We studied about PERT network diagram and how to draw it.
Yeah, we were in the next phase, that is our PERT diagrams. We completed our CPM and we moved on to our PERT diagrams. In the PERT diagrams, we started with seeing the three different time estimates. There's nothing but the expected time estimate, optimistic time, most likely time, and the pessimistic time. So these are the different types of time estimate parameters that we have seen. So right now, I'll share your screen and we'll start with the next problem. Okay, is the screen visible?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, yes, ma'am. Yeah, we have completed this problem. Hope you do remember this problem. We calculated the expected time, and out of that, we have calculated what is the expected duration. There is a maximum time duration as well as the critical path. These two parameters we calculated in the previous class. And now in this class, we are going to calculate the variance and standard deviation. These are the two additional parameters that we are going to calculate in today's class. So the second problem is the activity along with the predecessor are listed in the table below. So next slide, we do have the table. The optimistic time, the most likely time, and the pessimistic time estimates are listed in the table. Determine the expected time. So you are going to calculate the TE. So TE is nothing but our expected time that we are going to calculate, and we are also going to calculate the variance and the standard deviation. So I'm going to calculate the variance as well as my standard deviation. This is all three parameters we are going to calculate. So this is the table given in your question. So we have activities from A to G, and these are the predecessors TO, TL, and TP. So these values are given. And in this question, they didn't ask you to draw the network diagram. They have just told that they have given all your values, that is TO, TL, and TP values. These three values are given for all the activities. So by giving all those activities, they are just asking you only the expected time, standard deviation, the variance. If they have mentioned draw the diagram, then you have to draw. Unless it is mentioned in PERT, no need to draw the diagram. So in this case, again, now we are moving to our solution part. In the solution part also, the same parameters I'm going to carry over. The same table I'm going to draw, write it for my solution. Additionally, I'll be having my TE value, that is my time, expected time I'm going to calculate, and my variance as well as my standard deviation. These three columns I'm going to include. And you know the value formula used for TE, variance, and standard deviation. So using the formulas for each and every activity, we are going to calculate in the row wise. So the formulas used for expected time is nothing but TO plus 4TL plus TP divided by 6. And this is the formula used for calculating the expected time. And next value is, the next parameter is the variance. This is the TE. Using the formula which we saw in the previous slide, you are going to calculate it. TO plus 4TL plus 9 divided by your 6. This is the constant value. This is the divided by 6. When you do that, you will be getting this expected time estimate. For the you are going to use this formula for all the activities, and from activity A to G, you are going to calculate the TE values. Next, you are going to calculate the variance. Variance, you can either denote it by VT or sigma squared, so that you can name it as variance. But the formula used for that is TP minus TO divided by 6, the whole square. That is pessimistic time minus optimistic time divided by 6, the whole square. So when I use that, I have the pessimistic time as well as the optimistic time divided by 6. So again, here also 6 is a constant. Using that, I'm going to minus, find the difference, divide, and square root. So it is going to be the whole square. Sorry, not square root, it is going to be the whole square. Then I do get the value as 1.36. Now I'm going to calculate the standard deviation. Standard deviation is nothing but the square root of variance. So what will happen automatically? This square root of this value, that will give me this. So it is 1.17. So likewise, I calculate for all the activities. And as per the question, they have asked for determine the expected time for each activity. So TE I have calculated. Next parameter is calculate the variance. So that also I have calculated. And the next is the standard deviation. That's nothing but the square root of the variance. So that also we have identified. So this problem is over. So this is what they do. They'll be mentioning if they ask any values of telling find the expected time using the network diagram or draw the diagram. If they mention only have to draw the diagram, else it is not required. So we are done with this problem. Shall we move on to the next concept? Do you have any doubts in this?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So the next problem is, so we are done with a CPM as well as a PERT. So the next topic we are going to move is our project cost calculations. So you know, for every project we do have so many cost incurs. That may be our manpower, material, and your machinery. So all those costs are required. So we'll generally categorize this cost as three categories. One is total cost, direct cost, indirect cost. Total cost is nothing but the summation of direct and indirect cost. So the direct cost expenses, you know, it is a basic, there is a manpower plus your materials, equipments, those comes under your direct cost. Indirect cost goes under your overhead charges, maintenance, repairs, additional works that incur the cost. So that's going to be your indirect cost. So we'll be seeing one by one, we'll be seeing 3 to 4 definitions here that you have to do remember. That is most important, and that will be like whenever in future also when you are working in a project or when you're working in a firm, you should never forget those parameters, those 4 cost parameters. I'll tell you one by one. So first we'll see the cost considerations in a project. For any project, what are the costs that we'll be seeing and what are the basic things that we should consider? So project managers may have the option or requirement to crash the project or to accelerate the completion of the project. So you're working on a project, the deadline for that deadline or the completion time, expected completion time, I'm fixing it as 100 days. Okay. So if your client is putting on so much pressure, they want it by 90 days. So which means you have to work on faster to complete it 10 days. So that accelerating the speed towards the completion, that you call it as the crash. You're going to crash the project with a minimum time. So that is called crashing. This is accomplished by reducing the length of the critical path. You know, a critical path is going to give you the maximum possible duration. So example, maximum possible duration here is 100 days in our project. In our example, we took it as 100 days. So now we need the crash time as 90 days. So within 90 days, we need it. So we are going to crash it by 10 days. Do you agree? So the accelerated time you required is 90 days. Within 90 days, you need to complete. And critical path, that is going to be 100 days. In between the 10 days, you are going to crash it. So that time is going to be your crash time. The length of the critical path is required by reducing the duration of the activities on the critical path. And I just wanted to make a clarification. You don't have any classes after this, right? So can you pay me if I go 5 or 10 minutes extra out of a class session? Is it okay? If I take extra, is it okay for you? Then it will be easy for me to complete it on a stretch. Cases or no? I don't get any reply. Okay. So let me continue. Yeah, the length of the critical path is reduced by reducing the duration of activities. So I have the critical path that is going to be my CP. This critical path is nothing but it has the critical activities. You can simply call it as critical path always carries critical activities. Those critical activities, I am going to cut it down. I'm going to cut it down means I'm not going to completely avoid it, but I'm going to reduce it by a day or two so that I'll be completing my project at the earliest. If each activity requires the expenditure of an amount of money to reduce its duration by 1 unit of time, then the project manager selects the least cost critical activity. reduces it by one unit and traces that change through the remainder of the network. So if I am having two activities like this, I am having two activities. This is my first activity. This is my second activity and this is my third activity. So the duration here is 10 days and the duration here is again 10 days. So what I'm, so my critical path is 20 days. I wanted to crush it by 18 days. So what I do is I crush this activity. I change it to 8. I wanted to crush it. I mean, I want to crash it and bring it to 8, which means I'm going to reduce it by 2 days. For that 2 days, I'm going to put extra people, extra materials, extra resources to get that job completed 2 days prior. So I'm crashing here. I'm crashing this 10 days and bringing it to 8. So for the further calculations also, I should remember that the duration for the activity 2 to 3 is going to be only 8 now and it is not 10. So that is the, that change only you have to carry over to the remaining activity. So the progress you have to remember. The next is, as a result of a reduction in activities time, a new critical path may be created. Maybe that's true. In this case, you have only a single... Any disturbance? Kindly mute yourself. Okay. So, okay, no problem. So, what I'm going to do is I'm crashing here. When I crash it, I should remember now this 20 duration has reduced to 18. So here and after, I should take my critical path as only 18 days, not 20 days. Similarly, this is for a single, only two network, I mean, a simple activity, a simple network with two activities. If I have a complex structure where I have so many activities, in that case, when I'm crashing my critical path, that time I am having the possibilities of getting a new critical path even. When I'm having cluster of possible paths, in that situation, when I'm crashing, there are possibilities to get a single or multiple critical paths also. So when there is more than one critical path, each of the critical paths must be reduced. Do remember? They'll be asking this type of objective questions in your competitive exams. So when there is more than one critical path, in that situation, you are forced to crash. In that time, you're going to crash in your project. That time, you have to crash for your individual critical paths also. And next, if the length of the project needs to be reduced further, again, you have to repeat the process. So now we are moving to the cost model. What is meant by cost model? It's nothing but the cost to time relationship, or either you can call it as a time to cost relationship. The object of the network analysis is also to assess the possibility of arriving at a feasible and desirable time cost relationship. So everything in our construction sector, it is going to be cost and time bound. So as the gold rate is increasing, your sand rate is increasing, your steel rate is also increasing, your materials rates are increasing. So it is always sticking to your time. So based upon the time and your cost, it is always, so like it, whichever thing is, if you want to reduce the time, your cost will be increased. You have scheduled it for 100 days, but now I have to complete it by 90 days. So what I have to do, I have to put additional labors, I have to put require additional materials, so our extra machineries which could perform better to complete it, to shorten the time and complete it by 90 days. So the resource or the cost which I do require is going to be high if I prefer to go for crashing. If I need my job to be completed at the earliest, I have to spend more than the estimated cost for 100 days. So now, the overall project duration can be reduced by reducing the duration of the critical activities. So you have to reduce only the critical activities, because you know that critical path following critical activities has the maximum time limit or the maximum duration. That only you're going to crash it. The project cost is nothing but the summation of direct and the indirect cost. Like we have already seen what is direct and indirect cost, so we'll just have a glance and we'll move. Next is direct cost. Direct cost are those expenditures which are directly chargeable to and can be identified specially with the activities of the project. Those includes the direct labor cost, material cost, equipment cost. So the three M's that are going to be your direct cost. Indirect cost. Indirect cost is nothing but the indirect cost on a project are those expenses which cannot be apportioned or clearly allocated at the individual activities of a project, but you can assess it as a whole. Like on a whole, you can tell for this particular 1 year's project or just for 100 days project, you do require yourself 1 lakh or 2 lakh of indirect cost. But specifically for each and every activity, you cannot give it more precisely. It will be varying. The indirect cost includes the expenditure related to the administration and establishment charges, overheads, supervision, expenditure on a central store organization, loss of revenue, lost profit, penalty. So those are the different type of costs that fall under the head of indirect cost. The next is time cost relationship. Cost relationship. Crashing cost increase as project duration decrease. So what you're going to do, you're going to crash your project. You're going to cut your 100 days to 90 days, which means your time is reduced. Your time is reduced, but your cost will be increased. Definitely your cost will increase because you're going to cut down 10 days, which means those 10 days efforts or the work you're going to do it prior with additional resources. So your time cost will be increasing. So project duration decreases, which means time is decreasing. Indirect cost increases as the project duration increases. So this is your, this green color is your indirect cost. This cost is always going to increase when your duration increases. Next, reduce the project length as long as crashing costs are less than the indirect cost. So this is your direct cost. At the starting, it will be high. When for the extended time or when you're doing for the long duration, your direct cost will be lower. Now, like when you're crashing, what happens? You will be getting a combination of this part and this part. You will be getting cancelled. You will be having only this curvature. This curve will be having. Minimum cost equal to optimum time. For that, it's nothing but the total cost. You are going to add both your direct cost as well as your indirect cost. This graph you will be getting more clear only if you start working your problems. Next is project crashing. So as I told you, are going to crash your project. Crash your project is you have a tentative or estimated time. You're going to complete it in prior. You put additional efforts and complete it at the earliest. So that you call it as project crashing. Crashing is nothing but reducing the project time by expending additional resources. You spend more and get your job completed, which you can simply call it as your tatkal quota. That's true. You put more of money, you get it at the earliest. And crash time. It is an amount of time an activity is reduced. An amount of time that activity is reduced. So you are reducing it here by 10 days. So that time goes as your crash time. And crash cost. The cost of reducing the activity time. The cost that you are using here to reduce the 10 days. That cost is going to be your crash cost. And the goal. Goal to reduce the project duration at the minimum cost. So you have to complete, you need a minimum time at the minimum cost. You will be trying to fit it at the minimum cost, but definitely when you lessen or shorten your duration, your cost will be little higher compared to your expected cost. Next is your activity crashing. So in your activity crashing, you are going to plot your activity cost versus your time. Always do remember this is going to be your cost versus your time. Your time always will be in your x-axis. So in this situation, so this green color is going to be my normal cost. So I start my project here. Normally my cost will be the same level. It will not increase or decrease. And I do have my normal time, the same gradual time I'm going to do it. As per the schedule, I'm going to do it. So there will not be any ups or increase or hikes in my project cost. So it's going to be normal. The cost is also normal for the normal time. This is the time. For my time, the cost is normal. And now, say example, this is T. Now, I am going to complete it in D. So this is going to be my D. D is nothing but a crash time. So I wanted T minus D. So this will be my remaining will be my crash time. That is, I'm going to crash it in that particular time to bring it at the earliest. So here, this red dotted line indicates that it is my crash time. For the crash time, my crash cost will be high. So when I plot this, so I am plotting this crash cost versus my crash time, I get a point here. And similarly, normal cost versus normal time, I'm getting a point here. Now I should consider the slope for this. So when I calculate the slope, I'll be getting crash cost per unit time. So it is going to be, slope is nothing but crash cost per unit time. It's nothing but C divided by T, cost divided by per unit. That's going to be my CS, that's my cost slope. Cost slope is equal to crash cost per time. So C by T, I can literally say it as change in cost by change in time. I'll tell you how. So these are the terms which we are going to see. These terms are nothing but the normal time. You know that standard time or the estimated time of the particular project, you are having so much of activities to be carried over, you have some standard time. So that time is going to be your normal time. And the crash time, it's nothing but the minimum possible time in which an activity can be completed by employing extra resources. That is, additional amount or resources you put to get the job done at the earliest. It is the time beyond which the activity cannot be shortened by any amount of increase in resources. So next is normal cost. Normal cost, you know, you have some direct cost that you will be requiring for the particular task to be completed within the normal duration. Crash cost. I know that I'm going to crash my project. I'm going to complete it in prior, or I'm going to shorten my duration. That time, I have to put additional amount. So I'm going to crash that, I'm going to have some crash cost over there. Only then my time will be reduced. Crash cost is the direct cost corresponding to the completion of the activity with a crash time. So that particular, for the which activity I'm going to crash it, the cost incurred for that particular activity, I'm naming it as crash cost. So these are the formulas. It's nothing but cost slope. Cost slope is nothing but crash cost minus normal cost divided by normal time minus crash time. So you can also remember it as CC minus NC. CC is nothing but crash cost minus normal cost divided by NT minus CT. NT is your normal time. Normal time minus your crash time. So this will give you the cost slope. So CC minus CN divided by TN minus TC. You can either have it in this notation, or you can have it in this notation, or you can have it as a full form. It is left to you. So next, I am naming this as, it's nothing but, here is also cost, here is also cost. So it's nothing but the difference in cost. So I'm putting it as del C divided by del T. So I can say that my cost slope is equal to change in cost divided by change in time. So this is what I told in the previous also. So this is my cost slope is equal to change in cost by change in time. So yeah, is it clear up to this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next I'm going to the benefits of CPM. I think I didn't give you this particular slide. I have included here. It is nothing but the benefits of CPM and PERT. It's nothing but useful at many stages of the project management. So when you start your works in project management or in construction management, that time you will be using the CPM or PERT. Without this, you will not be having any management work taking place in your construction sector or your firms. So it is mathematically simple. Give critical path and slack time. it will help you to identify the critical path as well as the slack time. When you have the slack time, you can easily calculate your floats, and using the floats you can identify which is the critical path, or you can you can cross verify whether the path you have verified is the critical path. And provide project documentations useful in monitoring the costs. So now so these are the simple things. We don't want all those things. And these are the limitations of CPM and PERT. Okay, so this CPM and PERT, they are clearly defined independent and stable activities. Specified predecessor relationships do exist because we are already given, like when we have a table, for each and every activity, we'll be mentioning what is the immediate predecessor. So with that help of the predecessor only, you'll be able to draw your network. For knowing the relationship, basically you should know what are the list of activities or the hierarchy, order of construction activities that will be followed in practice, that you should know. And overemphasis on critical paths. So deterministic CPM models could be arrived. And activity time estimates are subjective and depend upon the judgments. So PERT assumes a beta distribution for these time estimates. It's nothing but your time estimates. You'll be having your optimistic time, pessimistic time, and your most likely time. You'll be having a probabilistic distribution. But the actual distribution may be varying. PERT consistently and underestimates the expected project completion time due to alternate paths becoming critical. So in PERT, when you're drawing your CPM, when your network diagram, in PERT, when you're drawing a network diagram, you may be having alternative critical path as well. You'll be having that also. So these are your limitations of the PERT. Okay. So next, we'll move on to the problem directly. Now we are going to see the crashing problem. So are you all along with me? Ma'am, what ma'am? We are going to have a vacation, ma'am. You're coming and sitting and taking problems, ma'am. Is it so? No, I know my students will not think like that. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we'll start this problem. Now we are going to do the crashing problem. The following table gives the duration of the project cost of each activity of the networks. Find the critical path and crash the activity by 2 days. So they have given you the activities and NT is the normal time. That is, you call it as the duration D that they have given. And NC, that is the normal cost. That cost is being given. And crash time, CT. Crash time in days. And this is days. So CT in days and crash cost in rupees. So for each and every activities, they have given corresponding values like this. So now what we are going to do is find the critical path and crash the activities. So you are going to draw the network diagram and tell me which is the critical path. You can start, you can take a paper or a note, have a pen or a pencil. Try out this diagram and tell me like what is going to be your critical path. So here you don't have the activity named as AB. If you have it by AB, you will be thinking whether you have to go for AOA or AOM. Here it is given clearly that it is 1 to 2, which means I'm going to have it like this. Activity 1, 2. Activity 2. My diagram is going to be like this. This is my activity 1. This is my activity 2. And next is 1, 2, 3. So activity 1, 2, activity 3. And the next thing is 2, 2, 4. Do I have any connection with 4? Yes, I do. 2 to 4 and 3 to 4, which means I have a common 4 here where both my 2 and 3 will end there. So this is my 2 to 4 and 2 to 3. So 3 to 4. Now I have 2 to 5 and 4 to 5. So I draw my 5 here. This is my 5. So I get connected with my 2 to 5 and 4 to 5. So this is my network diagram for this particular problem. So there are how many possible paths are there? 1, to 5. That is one possible path. And next is 1, 2, 4, 5 is one possible path. And the next is 1, 3, 4, 5. 1, 3, 4, 5. This is my list of possible paths. I do have 3 possible paths here. Now, I am marking my 3 possible paths. 1, 2, 5, 1, 2, 4, 5, 1, 3, 4, 5. I'm calculating my critical path. Here, I am getting 1, 2, 5. That is 8 plus 10. I'm getting it as 18 here. For this path, I'm getting 8 plus 2 plus 3. I'm getting it as 13. Whereas, in this case, I'm getting it as 4 plus 5 plus 3. I'm getting it as 12. So I am having only this as my critical path. 18 is my critical path. So now we can crash only the critical path. We can always crash only our critical path, as we saw in the previous definitions, because that is the maximum duration. We have to cut down the maximum duration. So I have my critical path here as 1, 2 to 5. This is my critical path. Out of this critical path, here I am having the duration as 8 and here I am having the duration as 10. Okay, so in the previous question, what they have mentioned, so I have found out my critical path. So this parameter I am done. And crash the activity by 2 days. They have mentioned that I have to crash my activity by 2 days. So what I am going to do is, I am having 8 plus 10 here, it is 18. I am going to cut down this 18 and bring it to 16. So this 10, I am going to take it as, I am going to crash it and take it as 8. That is what I am going to do. So as per the question, what they have mentioned is, I have to crash it by 2 days, which means 18 days should be reduced to 16 days. So this is the explanation for that. 8 plus 10 is 18. I am crashing that last activity by 2 days. So it is 8 plus 8 is 16. Now I know the formula for cost slope. Cost slope is equal to crash cost minus normal cost divided by normal time minus crash time. So this is my for my critical path. For my critical path, my activities are 1 to 2 and 2 to 5. For my 1 to 2, what is the cost slope here? For my activity 1 to 2, let me take another color. Yeah, for my activity 1 to 2, what are the parameters I should consider is my crash cost. Crash cost minus normal cost, that's nothing but 200 minus 100 divided by normal time minus my crash time, 8 minus 6. It is going to be 8 minus 6. So that's nothing but 200 minus 100 is 100. So 100 divided by 2, that is 50 rupees. So I am going to have this value as 50. So I can go and check that my value is going to be 50 rupees per day. And again, I am going to calculate for my 2 to 5 fifth activity. For that, I am going to calculate my cost slope. Why I am taking cost slope for both the activities are, it has been clearly given that for each corresponding activity, I do have different normal time, different normal cost, different normal crash cost and crash time. So that's the reason I consider only my critical path. So second phase of my critical path is 2 to 5, this activity. Again, here my cost is going to be 2 to 5. For 2 to 5, it is 400 minus 100. That is 300 divided by 10 minus 5. So 300 divided by 5, it is 60 rupees. 300 divided by 5 is equal to 60 rupees. So I have two different cost slopes. I should select only the least cost slope for crashing. So as I told you, this is my activity 1 to 2 and 2 to 5, where it has a duration of 18. That 18, I am crashing it to 16. I am crashing it by 2 days. So when I am crashing this, I should draw this network diagram and mention that I am cutting my 10 and writing it as 8, that I should draw and mention. So to crash the activities by 2 days. So this is my cost slope which I am preferring. Now they have mentioned in the question that I am crashing it by 2 days. So what I have to do is that 2 days into this crash cost, crash slope is there, this amount I have to take. So 2 into 50 rupees, that will give me 100 rupees. So what do you understand by this? 100 rupees is nothing, but if I crash it by 2 days, I have to spend an additional amount of 100 rupees. So the cost is going to be increased by 100 rupees. So is it clear?
Ma'am, in diagram you have written 2 to 5.
In diagram I have written.
No, ma'am, you have cut down that 10. Instead, we have to cut 8 now.
The thing is, I have written here in the left side and here I have written in the right side. Both are the same. I'm cutting 10 and writing it as 8.
No, my doubt was like you said, we have to take the minimum. So it is in activity 1 to 2.
I don't get you. No. This is not, we have to identify only that, we have to consider only the least cost slope. It doesn't mean that you have to cut it here. I'm having the value here as maximum value is 10 here. So I'm cutting that 10 by 8.
Okay.
So you in the critical path, you will be having many number of cost slopes, but it is always, you have to choose only the minimum cost slopes. Only then you will be able to identify your, how much amount is getting increased, you will be able to calculate. That's the reason we choose for the minimum cost. Okay. And you have to mention here that therefore, crashing by 2 days leads to increase in cost of rupees 100. I forgot to write it. That's the reason I wrote it at the pencil at the last. So you have to write it at the question. So whenever you're getting a question like this, either in your next CTs or your semesters, for that time, you have to mention this because they have asked you find the critical path and crash the activity by 2 days. So what will happen if you crash the activities by 2 days? If I crash it by 2 days, my cost will be increasing. That I have to mention. So that's the reason you have to give this explanation. Crashing by 2 days will lead to increase in cost of 100 rupees. Okay. So is it done? Shall we go to the next problem? Okay. So this is my second question. This is a simple question. And one question I'll give you as a homework. You can try it for your this vacation. And you can tell me what answer you got it. After the vacation, there is a first seminar day we'll be having, no? After your vacation, when will be having the first seminar? That is on Wednesday, I think so. So Wednesdays. Wednesday you are having CT.
Thursday.
Yeah, okay. So Thursday we'll be having the first seminar. That time you can tell me what answer you got for your third problem. We'll discuss that problem and then we'll go to the seminar. Okay. So this is our second problem. And IDC is nothing but the indirect cost. So indirect cost is equal to 3000 rupees per week. This has been given. Calculate the total cost incurred for the project. Okay, which means they have given the indirect, they are asking you the total cost. And you have to calculate the direct cost from the list of table given here. You have the table given here. Out of this, you can calculate what is your direct cost. Because for each and every activity, you know what is the normal cost. By using that, you can calculate what is your... Okay. So, you can calculate your direct cost. So, first, my activity is 1 to 2, 1 to 3. So, I am drawing one activity here that is 1 to 2. This is my 1 and this is my 2. Now, I am drawing an activity 1 to 3. This is my 1 to 3. This is done, this is done. So, next is my 2 to 3. So, 2 to 3 also I am connecting. Again, I have 2 to 4 and 3 to 4. So, I am going to have a common 4 where I am able to connect my 2 and 3 there. So, it is 2 to 4 and 3 to 4. So I have connected my network diagram. Don't forget to put this arrow marks. Okay. Yeah, I'm connecting it. Now I have the normal time duration. So similar to your conventional network diagram, you have to mention your durations also here. So my this duration is going to be 6 and 2 to 4 my duration is 5 and 2 to 3 my duration is 4 and 1 to 3 my duration is 8 and 3 to 4 my duration is 5. So I have mentioned my durations. Now I'm going to list what are the possible paths. So this are the basic mantras you should follow. When you draw a network diagram, put your time estimates, calculate the possible path, go identify your critical path. So I'm identifying the list of possible paths. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 4. So three different paths I'm having. If I go by 1, 2, 3, 4, that time only I'm getting my maximum duration, that is my critical path as 50. So I'm getting that. So critical path is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 is equal to 15 days, 15 weeks. So it gives me a total of 15 weeks. So next they have asked me to calculate the total cost. For total cost, you can ask, ma'am, they are mentioned only to calculate the total cost. Why should I calculate the critical path? So based upon how many weeks or days you have, based upon that only, you will be able to calculate your indirect cost. That's the reason you are calculating your critical path. Total cost is equal to the summation of direct cost plus indirect cost. So direct cost, you know, what is the direct cost? This is going to give you the direct cost. That is the summation of the entire normal cost is going to be the direct cost. 7,000 plus 4,000 plus 6,000 plus 8,000 plus 5,000. So this is going to give you a summation of 30,000. So this is going to be your direct cost. That is 30K. This is your summation. I mean, this is your direct cost. And now you are going to calculate your indirect cost. How you are going to calculate indirect cost? That is nothing, but they have given that indirect cost is equal to 3,000 rupees per week. So for per week, it is 3,000. So you can mention it as 3,000 into 15 weeks. You know that the critical path is telling you that the duration is 15 weeks. So 3,000 into 15, that is going to give you 45,000. So when you add this both, that will give you the total cost. Direct cost plus indirect cost will give you the total cost. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So first we saw the crashing problem and now we are seeing the cost calculation problem. So this is how you calculate your, yeah, this will be vice versa also, like they will be giving the direct cost and they will be asking you to calculate the indirect, or it will be twisted. But this is the formula and this is the concept you will talk to. Whatever diagram, whatever question you get, draw a network diagram, put the estimates, identify the possible path, come out with the critical path, then calculate your direct cost, go to your indirect cost, and finally end up with your total cost. So this is all related to your cost. And next, you can note down the problem which I give you. So this is your problem. So this problem alone you can take. You can take this problem. Yeah, this is a question. After this, you can copy. This is a simple thing I have started. So we saw the first example, right? That is in question one. We have crashed the activity by 2 days. So you know how to crash it. Crash is nothing but that 10 days you have cut and you have converted into 8 days. You know how to do that. Similarly, you are going to do this for your this problem also. So similar concepts you are going to apply here. So table gives the information about the various activities of the network as shown. I am giving you a simple problem, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, only 2 activities. So it is 9 and 5, 8,000 and 5,000, 6 and 3, 9,500 and 5,500 is a crash cost. So the project overheads are going to be rupees 300 per day, which means, which is the cost here? I mean, what cost is this? Project overheads cost means what cost?
Indirect
cost. So this 300 rupees per day is going to be my indirect cost. Determine the cost duration relationship, total cost duration relationship and the corresponding least cost plan. So I will give you an idea of how to do this problem. So you know, like you will be starting with your critical path. You know, there is only one possible way, so that's going to be a critical path. And as we calculate the cost slope, you will be calculating the change in cost and change in time, and you come out with a cost slope. So you will be considering this activity. You can either start with this and this. So when I consider with my 2 to 3 activity, I'm going to crash it. Again, similarly from my 1 to 2 activity, I'm going to crash it. While crashing, I should again draw the network diagram. I should identify what is the current duration. And I should use the same formulas to calculate my direct cost and indirect cost. So when I calculate it for activity 2 to 3, again I do it for my activity 1 to 2, and finally when I club it, I'll be getting my total, total cost. Again, finally, I have to come out with a graph stating that which is my normal cost, normal time versus normal cost, crash time versus crash cost. I have to mark this in my final diagram. And I have to show where is my direct cost, where is my normal cost, where is my direct cost, where is my indirect cost, and where is my total cost. All those three costs, you have to plot it in your... This is the second question, the total cost duration relationship and the corresponding least cost plan. So this I have to draw in the graph and show where is my direct cost versus time and total cost versus time. So you have to crash this problem, you have to do this problem, you have to crash the activities and come out with the graph. Is it okay? You do and tell me the results in next class. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Done. Now, so we are done with the third unit. Your next unit is going to be completely related to your contracts, tenders, and bids. So it is going to be a very theoretical unit. Your unit 4 and 5 are going to be theoretical, whereas unit 4 is completely theoretical, and unit 5 you have some practical implications of softwares. So that though it is going to be completely both the units are going to be theory, I don't want to keep grinding the same matters. So I have split you people into teams. I have sent you the Excel sheet. Did you all receive the Excel sheet? Did you all get your Excel sheet of the seminar topics and the team members?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so start preparing. So next week we'll be having batch 1 and 2. So come prepared, and people use this vacation whenever you're free. Like, I know you people are free this vacation. I don't want you dump with all those seminars. So take your time, at least 5 or 10 minutes each day. Or a single day you can sit for an hour and prepare for the seminar. I wanted you people to work together. I don't want a seminar or a presentation where out of 5, one will be sitting and doing all the presentation, one will be reading and explaining the others, and they'll come and do some blah blahs here. That I don't want. I want only teamwork here. All should be in teamwork. So your seminar is a kind of another CT, right, where you will be having some marks for it. So I wanted all of you to do it well in the seminar. So people who haven't done your CT properly, you can concentrate more and you can compensate it by working hard here. Okay, so you can prepare well, and I don't want any PPTs downloaded from the internet source and putting the same. I've seen so many people putting the same seminar presentation or the same, not even the dates and the logos changed. So I don't want any such things. I wanted you people to browse through books or through journals and take this contents. You can start preparing. If you have any doubts, you can text me in the Google Classroom. Again, I request you, I don't want any WhatsApp messages. Please put it in the group. I'll be checking it at least at least once in a day. So I'll be checking it. So please do put it in the group. I don't want in the WhatsApp group. Okay. Yes. Any other doubts? Let me cover all that events. So today's strength is only 77. Okay. Yes. Any doubts? No doubt, ma'am. Okay. From